there's tools out there to make your job easier, and finding Splashtop was my tool that I honestly say it saved our school year. Well, it first started, you know, like we went into shutdown and we didn't have a way to use any of the software. We kind of felt, you know, like, oh no, all the students paid for all the software that we have, you know, with their tuition and everything. So we wanted to make sure that they were able to use the resources that they paid for. I had one student email us saying, hey, I need to use the Adobe Acrobat, but I have a Chromebook and I can't use Adobe on it. So I started spinning my wheels, like, all right, well, before we use the VDI solution from engineering, maybe we could use that again. So I started building it up and putting it together, and it just was not the performance we needed. And then we started getting emails from other people asking about Autodesk and all these other Enscape to use in Revit. And we were just thinking, like, oh man, this is not going to be easy. And then we started getting questions about Avid and Edit, you know, like, because they were in the middle of filming for, you know, the end of the year projects. So we were kind of scurrying, like, all right, Windows can handle this with the VDI, but it can't handle Mac. And being in an art college, we needed a solution for Mac also. The students, they're, from what we hear from the instructors, they're using it, enjoying it. And what's nice is even the students who have a high-end MacBook Pro or a high-end gaming laptop, and they can run the software, it's nice to have this option of, like, hey, we have it, use it, just remote in, use our stuff, and continue on. Like, it took the program from being just great to now being awesome, because we can schedule course, you know, 20:32, and that meets Monday and Wednesday at 1 to 5 or 1 to 3. And you can set it, have all your students in there, and they'll get a reminder saying, hey, it's going to be 4 or 5 minutes and your course is going to end. And then they'll be bumped out and the next class can start. So having that for the new semester has changed the game. You know, like, me and my boss Gary and my coworker Chris, like, we're super excited that, you know, now we have the tools to really use this as a teaching portion. You know, it's an education program now. Like, it's been crafted to really handle what higher ed and, you know, even K-12 would need. And we're super excited about the fall semester, because it's like we got the schedules all set and we're ready to roll. All the security measures, you know, are great. There's the 2-factor authentication is wonderful. So if for some reason somebody would, you know, lose their password, like a student or a worker, they would get an email saying, hey, is this you trying to sign into this new device? So that's been great. And we have logs of everything. The logs are my best friend, because it's, you know, we can tell this device with this user was signed in at this time on this address, like IP address. So it's like you really can kind of crack down if you really need to investigate something. But luckily, we haven't had to do that. And knock on wood, we won't have to. Now we have a virtual open lab, which we always wanted in our college. And this year we got approved to have a open lab, but then the closure happened and now my open lab is virtually. And we would have never have had this if COVID would have happened. So now students can remote in to our labs no matter when. And also the open lab, you know, like they can jump in and out. We have about 50 free stations of just their virtual open labs. So it's nice to have that, and we'll always have that forever because it's just nice to have the ability to say, hey, you need to use the software, but you got to go home, remote it.